Would you want to see this picture on Facebook? This is not my hat. Where am I supposed to wear this hat, Quentin? Supposed to put it forward a little?
Yeah, that's
is it a little
cool.
bit like a Bowery boy, like the Notre Dame, the fighter on the...
You do, you look like somebody from the 1930s.
Listen, Quentin. You know, what you say on social media goes a long way for me, being that you're the only person I know who really uses this stuff a lot.
That may say
a lot about my friends, actually.
Well, I think my brain works in a very visual way, and I like the visual aspect of Facebook, and I think one of the... Like, you had... Facebook bought Instagram for $1 billion, seems like a lot of money, mm-hmm. and then there's Flickr and there's Pinterest, which is recently valued at, you know, around over $1 billion.
Sure, if you do something with photos,
it seems like and everybody's running around with their iPhones, and it seems like there's a sort of a gold rush for people's pictures.
Right. Now, you have a very, I read the piece, very interesting, actually. Why social networks want your photos, and the aspect that you bring out, which did not really occur to me, which should have, it's kind of obvious one, is that photos are very sticky.
You like this word, sticky. We discussed this before.
They're very, very sticky, and not
photos
only sticky, but we live in an age that is increasingly visual,
right,
and increasingly
pictures.
Superficial. And why describe what somebody looks like now? Why not just share the photo? I mean, that kind of makes sense to me.
Right, you want to see what other people are doing. We're very voyeuristic. We want to see if somebody's put on weight since high school. We want to see if they have... what kind of hats they're wearing.
Right.
People like other sites like Pinterest, which is a scrapbook site, which is really people generating their own content and creating an online magazine. And Pinterest just sit there and help them do that by choosing random pictures from the web. So people get to show that they... Well, somebody put it to me like Facebook is like this online equivalent of reality television, that everybody gets to become
stars
in their own lunchtime, but
right.
longer than 15 minutes,
right.
for as long as their profile is active.
But do people, and of course I'm generalizing, which is the problem
right.
with all this thing, you know, some people care, other people don't care. I mean,
right.
you know, a little of this is like, you know, people, if you come over to my house, I'll show you my photo album. But who really wants to go through the photo
Betty
album? Do people really want to go through
yes,
people's
because
photos?
Because Betty White said, you know, when she hosts Saturday Night Live, photo albums used to be like the worst thing you could do to your neighbors is to bring them in and show your vacation pictures, because you had to sit there for an hour and go through them.
You had to actually spend time with your so-called friends.
Yes, but now you get to be a voyeur and you get to go through them at your leisure and you can flick through them, pick out the ones you like, so you're in control. So that's a major part of it.
Right.
You know, 6 billion photographs are shared on Facebook every month. Estimated.
That's just
scary. A lot of pictures. So,
photos take up a lot of data space. I mean, when are they going to charge for any of this stuff?
I think they're going to have to start charging for something. I think Facebook would be perfect actually for a dating website, because all the pictures are there. You're not going to move them, so they could start charging people. For a dating service.
Quentin Fittrell on Why Social Networks Want Photos. This is on smartmoney.com?
Smartmoney.com.
Check it out. You don't want to miss that. Here's your hat back.
Thank you.
Thank you very much, Quentin.